School, but you didn't meet till later. Yeah. 25 years later at the high school reunion. That is the best story. I love that. Yeah, you stand right here, right now, the beginning of an amazing adventure, and that's your marriage to each other. The adventure of marriage is not the reckless abandoning of yourself, your individuality, or your future. It is, rather, the sincere, confident, humble invitation for the love of your life to join you in all that you are, all that you have, and all that you hope to be. See, marriage is a covenant. It's a covenant of promises that are written on the pages of your heart. It's a covenant that says, I can't be certain where the rest of my life will take me. I'm only certain that I want you to go there with me. And because life promises no one wealth, fame, or perfect health, the promise that you make to each other today is a promise that in the best of times, in your moments of greatest celebration, the love of your life, they will be there with you, they will be there for you. And in the worst of times, in seasons of loss and distress, this same person, they will be there with you, they will be there for you. You see, when you hold onto your loved one's hand, they're holding your hand right back with a grasp that says, I am your greatest fan. I am the most determined believer in who you are and who you can be. I believe that loving you is willing your highest good, and in your race to achieve your purpose and your goals, I will be that voice shouting from the sidelines, go for it, you can do it, I believe in you. And because loving each other is willing each other's highest good, love never gives up. Love believes with relentless conviction. Love doesn't compete because competition leads to envy. Love doesn't boast. Love honors by first considering the needs of the other. Love does not keep score of one another's mistakes. Love seeks to always express itself in truth and faithfulness. Love is patient and love is kind. Love looks for the best in each other, believes the best of each other. Love never fails. And when the two of you disagree, love chooses not to consider it a personal victory when one person's will is imposed on another person's will, but rather love strives for resolutions that promote mutual respect, honor, and satisfaction. In other words, love says, I can't win, not if it means you lose. And when the story of your life is told, I hope that your love defines the highest, most sacred achievement in human relationship, and that's a marriage. Right, flowers, please. As you turn and face each other, hold both hands, look into each other's eyes. Deann, Larry, you both stand here inviting your best friend to share the rest of your life with you, to share your hopes and your dreams for the future. When life brings those moments of celebration, know that your greatest joy, your highest sense of completion, be to share those moments with each other. And in the seasons of sorrow and disappointment, your greatest comfort be the compassion and understanding that shines from the eyes of the friend that you now take in marriage. Larry, if you take Deann, To be your wife and promise to be faithful to her and honest with her, to respect and trust her and stand by her side, which you pledge to her, an exclusive intimacy that you reserve for Deann alone. And in the good and the bad, happy and the sad seasons of your life, if you commit yourself to her in this covenant of marriage, if this is your sincere promise, would you please say, I do.
I do.
Deann, in like manner, particularity to your husband. Promise to be faithful to him and honest with him. If you'll respect and trust him and stand by his side, if you'll pledge to him your exclusive intimacy that you reserve for Larry alone, and in the good and the bad, the happy and the sad seasons of your life, if you commit yourself to him in this covenant of marriage, if this is your sincere promise, please say, I do.
I do.
The endless circle of this ring is a symbol of your unending love. With this ring, you pledge to each other your future. You give this ring as a sign that you've chosen each other, that you honor, respect, and celebrate one another, and that you honor, respect, and celebrate the promises that your ring represents. Very slowly, place it on the end's finger. These two candles burn in symbolic representation of your life as individuals under this moment. They're burning here bright with the hope and the promise of your future together. I'd like you to both take a candle. Come on now.
There it goes.
And together, light a flame that represents two becoming one. Allow me the privilege of praying a blessing. And now, God in heaven, I pray your blessing over this union, the blessing of Deann, the blessing over Larry. I pray that you shower their marriage and their home with health and happiness and wisdom and understanding and laughter. Please bring to them good friends and warm relations who will encourage them and help them to celebrate the commitment that they make to each other today. May they live each day with the courage to live out their convictions, and may a very great conviction be that you have brought them together for a purpose. Pray these things in your holy name. Amen. Larry, Deann, along with family and friends who have come to celebrate you and make this memory with you, it's been our pleasure to witness your pledge to love, honor, and cherish each other. I believe in the power of love. I believe in the sanctity of your union. Even your commitment to build a life together makes me very proud to pronounce you husband and wife. You two may seal your promises with a kiss. Yes? All right, would you one more time celebrate the union?